two pieces of artwork are from the later Gothic period. The painting is called The Equestrian Portrait of Guidoriccio da Fulliano. This painting was developed in the later Gothic time period by an Italian painter named Simone Martini in 1330. Simone Martini was a major influence to international Gothic style art. The art technique used is fresco, wet paint applied to wet plaster. This portrait is opposite the Maestra, another one of Martini's famous paintings. It is located in the room of the Sala de Consiglio, which in English is translated to Grand Council Chamber. This room is part of the Palazzo Pubblico, translated to Town Hall, a palace located in central Italy. According to painting in the late medieval and early Renaissance Siena, 1260 to 1255, a book source that I had used for this project. This painting extends the entire width of the upper part of the wall. There is also a painting below it, pictured here, called The Submission of a Castle. The subject of the painting is identified as Guidoriccio da Fulliano. He was a Siennese leader who captured the fortress of Montemasse. During this time period, Italy was not a unified country and was divided into various city-states. Therefore, Guidoriccio da Fulliano, from the city-state of Siena, was commemorated for capturing the fortress through this self-portrait. One can see the fortress gates having various arrows against the wall, which may represent successful attack on the fortress. Additionally, one sees a well-established military camp on the side of the picture, where one can assume that is where Guidoriccio's soldiers reside. Guidoriccio's tactfulness and leadership is reflected in this painting, as one sees that his face looks very stern, determined, and even majestic, with the horse covered with the same cloth and design as his clothes. There has been some controversy with this painting, as it was originally credited to Simone Martini. The dispute has been that this painting may have been remade in the 15th century by a different artist. Although nothing has been confirmed, the controversy still remains.
Called The Annunciation, Nativity, and Adoration of the Shepherds by Nicola Pisano in Pisa, Italy, from 1259 to 1260 within the Gothic art. This marble relief is located in Pisa Baptistry and depicted on the dome of the pulpit. Throughout the Middle Ages, the Byzantine style dominated Italian paintings, but its influence was especially strong after the attack of the Constantinople by the Crusaders in 1204. As a result, this precipitated a migration of the Byzantine artists to Italy. Nicola Pisano received most of his influences in southern Italy. He was taught by the army of craftsmen who Frederick II had employed to decorate his projects. In Pisa, Nicola was also exposed to additional classical works in and around the cathedral, including early Christian sarcophagi, as well as French Gothic influences. Some scholars may say that the pulpit at the Pisa Baptistry to be one of the first modern sculpture. This panel from one of the pulpit's upper panels in medieval fashion portrays a hierarchy of size to emphasize the importance and imperfect pro-resonance form. Each of the figures' faces are classical in proportion. The pulpit contains three panels that depicts the infancy cycle of Christ by the Annunciation, Nativity, and Adoration of the Shepherds. In the central scene, a large depiction of Mary who looms over what seems like workers washing Christ after birth. Overall, the Pisano pulpits had a large contribution to the changing perceptions about the nature of religion and the world. They are the earliest visual art in Italy, as part of the increasing respect for application of knowledge and the nature of religious experience.